Good afternoon, everyone. This is Dr. Siksha Swarupakar, working as principal scientist in CRRI. So right now we are talking about bitumen emulsion and cold mixes. So first of all, I just want to ask, have you worked with bitumen emulsion? कोई काम किए हैं bitumen emulsion में यहाँ पे MPRRT में या काम ही नहीं हुआ है? हुआ है? आप लोग काम किए हैं emulsion में? Prime coat, tag coat और OGPC seal coat सब में काम किया हुआ है? ठीक है. सो फर्स्ट, वाई वी आर गोइंग फॉर द कोल्ड मिक्स? व्हाट इज़ द नीड फॉर द कोल्ड मिक्स? व्हाई नॉट कन्वेंशनल बिटुमेन मिक्सेस? सो इफ़ वी टॉक अबाउट द एनवायरमेंट कंसर्न, देन इफ़ वी आर गोइंग टू कंस्ट्रक्ट ए हॉट मिक्स पेवमेंट यूजिंग कन्वेंशनल हॉट मिक्स फॉर 50 mm 1 km रोड, देन वी आर एमिटिंग ए पॉल्यूशन अबाउट 1200 टन्स ऑफ CO2, विच इज़ इक्विवेलेंट टू 210 पैसेंजर कार्स moving around the globe for a year. So this much emission we are polluting for constructing only 1 km of road. So these are the major issue, because right now environmental pollution is a major factor. We need to go for environmental friendly technologies. That's why we are going for this cold mix, which is the replacement of hot mix in terms of environment friendly. So दीज आर सम फोटोग्राफ्स. ये जैसे हम लोग हीट करते हैं, कन्वेंशनली गर्म करते हैं, तो आपने देखा होगा बहुत सारा एमिशन होता है. सो दीज आर सम फोटोग्राफ्स. मैनुअली वी आर डूइंग, इफ़ वी आर डूइंग बाई प्लांट देन ऑल्सो वी आर एमिटिंग लॉट्स ऑफ पॉल्यूशन. सो वी ऑल नो दैट इन कन्वेंशनल हॉट मिक्स वी हैव टू हीट द बिटुमेन एंड एग्रीगेट अप टू 160 to 180 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. आपको बिटुमेन को हीट करना पड़ता है, बिकॉज बिटुमेन इन रूम टेम्परेचर ये सॉलिड स्टेट में रहता है. इट्स ए विस्को इलास्टिक मटेरियल. जैसे रूम टेम्परेचर में वो सॉलिड रहता है, आप हीट करोगे तो ये लिक्विड फॉर्म में आएगा. सो आफ्टर लिक्विड फॉर्म यू कैन कोट इट ओवर द एग्रीगेट. दैट्स व्हाई यू नीड टू हीट द बिटुमेन एंड ऑल्सो द एग्रीगेट टू हैव ए प्रॉपर कोटिंग. सो इन कन्वेंशनल मेथड वी हैव टू हीट द एग्रीगेट एंड ऑल्सो बिटुमेन. आपको 160 to 170 डिग्री तक हीट करना होता है एग्रीगेट एंड बिटुमेन को, और कंपैक्शन भी हाई टेम्परेचर में करते हैं. So due to the heating we are consuming lots of energy, and also we are emission is there, pollution is there, and it is not good for health of the labor. Noise pollution is there. So इसीलिए we need to go for low energy solution. Now we are doing the research for low energy solution. So if we talk about low energy solution, then when we are reducing the energy consumption for construction of bituminous pavement, that mixes we call it as a low energy mixes. तो इसमें क्या होता है, आपका energy consumption reduce हो रहा है without compromising the performance. कि without compromising the performance we have to reduce the energy consumption in case of low energy mixes. So you can see this picture आप देख सकते हैं. यहाँ पे आपका हॉट मिक्स है जो आपका 150 to 180 डिग्री में मिक्स किया जाता है और पेविंग किया जाता है. सो और एक मेथडोलॉजी इज देयर, वॉर्म मिक्स एसफॉल्ट. उसमें क्या होता है, आपका 30 to 40 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड यू आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द टेम्परेचर ड्यूरिंग द मिक्सिंग एंड कॉम्पैक्शन. तो दैट इज़ वॉर्म मिक्स एसफॉल्ट, एंड अदर वन इज़ द कोल्ड मिक्स एसफॉल्ट. सो इन केस ऑफ, डू यू एनीबडी इज़ हैविंग एनी नॉलेज अबाउट वॉर्म मिक्स? हैव यू वर्कड? आप लोग कुछ काम किए हैं वॉर्म मिक्स एंड कोल्ड मिक्स में? डिफरेंस आप बता सकते हैं. इन केस ऑफ वॉर्म मिक्स एसफॉल्ट क्या होता है, आपका बिटुमेन में यू आर एडिंग ए एडिटिव सो दैट द विस्कोसिटी और द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ बिटुमेन आपका लो टेम्परेचर में दैट कैन बी कोट ओवर द एग्रीगेट. आपको जो लिक्विड चाहिए वो लो टेम्परेचर में, 30 to 40 डिग्री लो टेम्परेचर में. जी येस, इन जाइकोथर्म यू हैव टू ऐड दैट जाइकोथर्म इन टू द बिटुमेन एट 120-130 टेम्परेचर. देन वो आपका मिक्सिंग और कॉम्पैक्शन 110 to 140 में हो जाएगा. दैट इज़ नोन एज द वॉर्म मिक्स. इन केस ऑफ कोल्ड मिक्स दैट इज़ एट एम्बियंट टेम्परेचर, वी आर नॉट यूजिंग बिटुमेन इन दिस केस, वी आर यूजिंग बिटुमेन इमल्शन. सो बिटुमेन इमल्शन इज prepared out of bitumen only. We have to prepare the bitumen emulsion, but that is altogether a different products. It's not a bitumen. ये क्या होता है, ये आपका liquid state में रहता है. आपको पता होगा emulsion के बारे में आपने जाना ही होगा कि हम day to day life में भी बहुत सारा emulsion use करते हैं. कुछ example आप दे सकते हैं emulsion होता क्या है और हम लोग क्या use करते हैं? Like milk is a emulsion. आपका जो हम दूध पीते हैं दैट इज़ ए इमल्शन. वाट एवर वी आर यूजिंग ए शैम्पू दैट इज़ ऑल्सो ए इमल्शन. सो इमल्शन क्या होता है, जब टू इमिसिबल लिक्विड वी आर मिक्सिंग टूगेदर, वी आर मिक्सिंग फॉर ए होमोजीनियस मिक्सचर, दैट इज नोन एज द इमल्शन. सो बिटुमेन इमल्शन ये होता है, बिटुमेन और वाटर दो इमिसिबल लिक्विड है, दिस टू आर टू इमिसिबल, ऐसे मिलाएंगे तो मिलेगा नहीं, बट वी आर मिक्सिंग थ्रू ए केमिकल प्रोसेस टू गेट ए इमल्शन. ओके, इन दिस बिटुमेन इमल्शन बिटुमेन इज डिस्पर्स्ड. लाइक आपका इमल्शन में क्या होता है, एक जो लिक्विड है वो छोटा छोटा पार्टिकल होके दूसरे लिक्विड में डिस्पर्स होके रहता है, तो ये आपका इमल्शन बनता है. मैं बाद में स्लाइड में दिखाऊंगी हाउ इट इज डिस्पर्स्ड इनटू ए टू लिक्विड्स डिस्पर्स्ड, वन लिक्विड डिस्पर्स्ड इनटू अदर. सो ये आपका इमल्शन होता है. तो इमल्शन इज लिक्विड फॉर्म एट रूम टेम्परेचर, सो वी डोंट नीड टू हीट द एग्रीगेट एंड हीट द इमल्शन, दैट कैन बी कोटेड ओवर द एग्रीगेट एट ए रूम टेम्परेचर एंड विथ टाइम द वाटर इज इवेपोरेटेड. उसका प्रोसीजर होता है एंड आपका फाइनली मिक्स कॉम्पैक्ट करके सेट होता है. एंड द इमल्शन, देर इज़ ए प्रॉब्लम विथ इमल्शन दैट वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट दैट मच स्ट्रेंथ वाट वी आर गेटिंग इन कन्वेंशनल हॉट मिक्स. सो इमल्शन बी जनरली यूज फॉर द रूरल रोड कंस्ट्रक्शन, फॉर लो वॉल्यूम रोड when traffic is below 2 msa and where we are going for a wearing coat, where we are not talking only, we are talking about riding quality and we are not talking about any structural strength, in that case we can use emulsion very easily, there is no issue with using the emulsion. So history of cold mix, if I talk, then it's not a new technology, it's a very old technology. So it has been used in US from 1970, but in India we are using this technology from 2005 onwards only. We are not using this technology till now very frequently. There are many apprehension while we go for a emulsion cold mix. Abhi bhi isko new technology ke andar mein hi count kiya jata hai. This emulsion cold mix is counted into the new technology methodology. So if you talk about global emulsion market, we all know that India is the second largest road network. आपको पता ही होगा कि हमारा second largest road network है. And आप बता सकते हैं कि rural road कितना है, total अगर road network कितना percentage rural road है? Yeah. If we talk about rural road and ODR, MDR जो low volume road है, something about 97% are rural road. Only 1-2% are of national highway, other are of rural road. Then also we are not high consumer of emulsion, because we are not going for the emulsion technology, we are going for the conventional hot mix. So we are in 3% only we are consuming emulsion if we see the global market emulsion consumer. Then coming to the emulsion, what is emulsion? So in case of cold mix, in case of binder, we are using emulsion aggregate at room temperature, we are coating, then we are paving. So now talking about emulsion, so this is a emulsion two liquid, the globules are bitumen and this is the water. So आपका bitumen क्या होता है, bitumen छोटा छोटा particle 0.1 to 0.3 micron का छोटा particle बना के हम disperse करते हैं through a colloidal mill, मतलब एक mill में वो run होता है, तो आपका bitumen का छोटा particle होके disperse होता है. अगर आप बोलेंगे ये disperse कैसे, ये settle कैसे रह रहा है, बिकॉज आपका दो इमिसिबल है तो सेटल नहीं होना है. सो वी आर यूजिंग ए इमल्सीफायर एजेंट, तो वी कॉल इट एज ए इमल्सीफायर एजेंट. सो दिस इज ए इमल्सीफायर एजेंट, स्टेबिलाइजर, यू कैन कॉल इट एज ए स्टेबिलाइजर इन दिस केस. सो वॉट इज हैपनिंग, दिस स्टेबिलाइजर इज हैविंग टू एंड, वन इज योर हाइड्रोफिलिक एंड, अदर वन इज हाइड्रोफोबिक एंड. वॉट यू मीन बाई हाइड्रोफिलिक, डू हैव एनी आइडिया? वाटर लविंग. वॉट यू मीन बाई हाइड्रोफोबिक? वाटर हेटिंग. So these are two end, one is hydro, this is your water, this is your asphalt. So this end we call it as a head, which is having hydrophilic. So it is attached with the water only. So other end is your hydrophobic, that will attach with the bitumen. So through this stabilizer we can stabilize, we can prepare a emulsion. So we can change the emulsifier depending, there are many chemistries involved into this, I am not going into deep into the chemistry, but this is the methodology where we can prepare the emulsion. This is the thing, emulsion, two immiscible liquid mixed together is known as the emulsion. Then how the emulsion cold mix, what is happening with the aggregate coating, how it is, do you have any idea that why we are using cationic emulsion, why not anionic? Do you know what is cationic and what is anionic emulsion? Anyone? आप बता सकते हैं cationic emulsion क्या होता है? जी या in case in our Indian situation scenario, we are using cationic emulsion mainly because हमारा जो aggregate रहता है, we are having the negative charge over the aggregate in Indian scenario. हमारा जो quartz और जो भी surface charge negative होता है, तो in case of cationic emulsion, जो emulsifier हम choose करते हैं for preparation of emulsion, there we are having a positive charge over the emulsifier. So when it is going come contact, it is coming contact, emulsion is coming contact into the aggregate. So आपका positive negative charge में electrostatic attraction होता है and there is a bonding between the aggregate and emulsifier is also happening. And उसमें आपका water with for the environment condition water evaporate होके आपका set होता है. So this procedure setting of emulsion, initial setting is known as the breaking. Like आप जब mix करते होंगे emulsion aggregate में कौन सा color आता होगा आप brown. हाँ with time it is converting into the black. So this is known as the breaking of the emulsion. Brown to black convert हो जाता है. आपने देखा होगा field में brown होता है that time adhesion नहीं होता है दोनों के बीच में ऐसे ही mix होता है but जब black होता है तब adhesiveness आ जाता है. तो that phenomena we call it as a breaking of the emulsion. Okay. So type of emulsion cationic anionic and depending on the setting time breaking time or setting time the emulsion is divided into rapid setting medium slow setting and modified emulsion. So in case of micro surfacing we are using modified emulsion for micro surfacing that is a preventive maintenance system. So tomorrow I think there is a lecture on maintenance rural road maintenance system. In that micro surfacing detail of microsurfacing will go through. So I think Manoj sir or Rajiv are you going to take that lecture? Shukla sir is going to take that lecture. There microsurfacing. So whenever you are going to use bitumen emulsion, first you need to do some testing at laboratory to see the properties of the emulsion whether that is suitable, whether the emulsion is stable. वो emulsion आप use कर सकते हैं या नहीं कर सकते हैं. तो these are some properties you need to do check at laboratory before using the emulsion. And these properties we do check as per the IS 8887 Indian Standard 8887 2018 is there. So उसमें emulsion का properties and what should be the range कि what is the range of emulsion that is there. So as per that we need to do the check. So residue on 600 micron viscosity we need to check to see the pumpability availability आपका pump कैसे होगा if you are going for a hot mix plant और आप mix कर रहे हो तो उसके लिए we do check the viscosity. Residue on 600 micron we do check for the to check the impurity. What is the impurity? Is there any impurity? Is there in the emulsion? Then storage stability we check to check the homogeneity because two liquids are mixed together whether that is stable or not. कि आपका स्टेबल है या अलग हो जा रहा है कि पार्टिकल सेपरेट हो रहा है. फॉर दैट वी नीड टू डू द स्टोरेज स्टेबिलिटी. पार्टिकल चार्ज टू चेक वेदर इट इज़ ए कैटायनिक इमल्शन और एनायनिक इमल्शन. फॉर दैट वी नीड टू डू द पार्टिकल चार्ज एंड मेनली व्हाट विल हैपन द फाइनल आउटपुट फाइनल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द मिक्स डिपेंड्स ऑन द बिटुमेन. हाउ मच बिटुमेन इज देयर. सो फॉर दैट वी नीड टू चेक द बिटुमेन कंटेंट इन द इमल्शन क्योंकि इमल्शन में दो वो है एक वाटर है एक बिटुमेन हो गया. बिटुमेन अराउंड 60 रहता है वाटर 40. अगर बिटुमेन आपका 50% आ गया वाटर 50 हो गया तो आपका प्रॉपर्टीज फाइनल प्रॉपर्टीज में बिटुमेन कम आ गया ना. सो इसीलिए यू नीड टू चेक द माइनर कंटेंट ऑफ दैट इमल्शन बिफोर गोइंग फॉर द फील्ड मिक्सेज. यू नीड टू चेक इन लेबोरेटरी व्हाट इज द माइनर कंटेंट ऑफ दैट इमल्शन. So test on residue also we need to and whatever the binder is available on that binder also we need to check penetration ductility and solubility check to check the binder properties. The available binder what is the property of binder whether that is suitable or not. So these are some tests we need to do before field application. So residue on 600 micron sieve. It's a simple test. You need to have a 600 micron sieve. Then you have to pass the emulsion over that sieve, weighted amount of emulsion through that sieve and precaution you need to do ki sieve ko aapko acche se clean karna hoga through solvent. If in that sieve some amount of dust is there to emulsion aapka break ho jayega aur aapka bitumen particle upar mein reh jayega to you are not going to get the proper result. So whenever you are using sieve test and you are using a sieve in for this then you need to clean the sieve properly with the solvent then you have to do this test to check the impurity. अगर आपका impurity ज़्यादा है then you can't use that emulsion. Then coming to the viscosity by Sebold Viral Viscometer, this is the viscometer available in market. So you need to check the viscosity to check the pumpability ability of the emulsion. So in this emulsion ka generally we do check at 25 degree centigrade, otherwise 50 degree some emulsion. So this is a water jacket where aapka temperature check, temperature constant rakh sakta hai yahan pe emulsion ka. Then orifice is there, so you have to remove that plug and you have to measure the time required to flow 60 ml of emulsion into that beaker. So from there you can calculate the viscosity of the emulsion. Then coming to the storage stability, it's a very essential parameter to check the homogeneity. As I say, there are two liquid are there. So ye aapka jo फोटो देख रहे हैं, दिस इज नॉट ए बिटुमेन इमल्शन, सम अदर इमल्शन, बट इज दैट होमोजीनियस, इज दिस इमल्शन इज होमोजीनियस? अगर ये कुछ इमल्शन नहीं, ये होमोजीनियस है क्या आपके हिसाब से? नहीं है. व्हाई दिस इज नॉट होमोजीनियस, व्हाई वाज सेम लेयर अलग हो गया? सिमिलरली बिटुमेन इमल्शन इज ऑल्सो हैविंग टू कंपोजिशन, दैट इज वाटर एंड बिटुमेन. सो इफ बिटुमेन इमल्शन इज नॉट होमोजीनियस, देन टू लेयर विल बी देयर. बिटुमेन because having higher specific gravity, it will settle down and water will go up. So in this case, what you need to do at laboratory, you have to keep the bitumen in this graduated cylinder for 24 hours. And if you want to check vigorously, then you can keep it for 3 days also without moving it. So after 24 hours, you can take 50 ml from the top emulsion, then bottom, from bottom through pipette you can take 50 ml in two beakers. Then you need to check the binder content of the top portion and bottom portion. Agar aapka binder content ka difference jyada hai, if the difference is more than 0.5% or 1% as per the requirement given in IS 8887, then that emulsion is not homogeneous. Aapka binder niche settle ho gaya hai. So this is the test you need to do, ki first take 50 ml from the top, 50 ml from the bottom, after keeping it for 24 hours without any movement, then you take the bitumen emulsion from, then you check the binder content of the emulsion to see the homogeneity of the emulsion. Okay, then particle charge to check whether it is a cationic or anionic, because in sometimes in manufacturing unit there must be some issue or anionic emulsion if formation. So you need to check the particle charge. This is a simple battery is there and one cathode and anode is there. So you have to put the emulsion over the cathode and anode, then the particle charge, if it is a cationic, then it will settle over the cathode. So you are going to get the particle charge, which kind of emulsion is there. Then residue by evaporation to check the binder content, because this is also a major parameter to check whether the emulsion as per the required, because finally whatever the performance is going to happen, if the binder is less in the mix, then it is going to, raveling is there. So you need to check the binder, proper binder content is there or not. So you have to keep the emulsion in a beaker, then you keep it in an oven for 163 degrees centigrade for 3 hours. And you need to do 3 replicates. Whatever test you are doing as per the IS 8887, you need to do 3 replicates to check the proper results. So in this also you have to keep the emulsion in the beaker, then keep it in oven for 163 degree, and glass rods, you have to mix the emulsion using a glass rod in between. Then finally, after some time, water will evaporate, only the binder will be there. So whatever emulsion you have taken in the beaker, you have already weighted that one. If you are taking 500 gram or 150 gram of emulsion, that you know the weight, then after evaporation water, you can weight it again, then you can calculate the water content, bitumen content over the emulsion. So that should be as per the range given in IS 8887. And same test you have to do with that storage stability, from top portion and bottom portion you have to take the emulsion and do the binder content. So binder content difference should not be more than 1%. And this is the requirement. I think it is not visible to you all, but I'll give this code to you all. This is IS 8887, and as per that we have RS1, RS2, MS, SS1, SS2, 5 kind of emulsion for 5 different application. So these are some requirement. Like if we talk about the residue on 600 micron, then that should at me maximum 0.05% should be there. If the residue is more than 0.05%, that emulsion is not as per the requirement. And viscosity is given. We are doing the viscosity for RS1, RS2 and MS for 50 degree centigrade, and the range is given. And similarly for SS1, SS2 we do for 25 degree centigrade. And आपका जैसे binder content हो गया, residue binder content for RS1 and SS2 that is 60% is minimum. If you are going for RS2, 76% is binder is required. So you need to check the binder content. And for MS, 65% is required. So these are some range given in IS 8087. Whatever you are going to check in the laboratory, that should be in between in this range. Then coming to the recommended, because there are 5 types of emulsion, so same emulsion can't work for the same application. So all emulsion is having different application depending on the property. So RS1 we generally do use for the tack coating. It is used for the tack coating, and RS2 is generally used for the surface dressing. Whenever we are going for surface dressing or penetration grouting, in that case we are using RS2. And MS, medium setting emulsion, we do use for the premix carpet or surface dressing also. You can use the MS medium setting. And SS1 is used for the priming. So if you are using SS1, then only for the prime coat you can use the SS1. And SS2 is used for all kind of MSS, HDBC, because semi-dense bituminous concrete is also there, we can use the emulsion in that case. So for that we have to use SH2, and right now we are using recycling, and recycling also we are using emulsion. So SH2 emulsion is used for the recycling mix also. And modified emulsion, that will be used only for the micro surfacing, which is a preventive maintenance, and tomorrow there is a lecture on this. So this code, whatever data I am giving you, as per IRC SP100. So there is a code, IRC code, Indian Road Congress code, IRC SP100, where all kind of emulsion and its application is given in that code. So before going to apply in field or anywhere, you should go through that IRC SP100. Okay. So these are some precaution you need to do when you are using emulsion. So if we are using for tack coat or prime coat or any kind of emulsion spraying application, then first you need to clean the WMM or WBM surface. If there is some dirt or dust, more dust is there, then your emulsion is going to settle and break immediately, and it is not going to consume more. You are needing more emulsion, so whatever the required emulsion, you are not going to get total coverage of that one. So you need to clean the surface before using any kind of application. And then coming to the emulsion, you have to always take emulsion from the tight drum. If drum is open and keep it for 5 hours or 7 hours or 24 hours, then that emulsion is not suitable, because that is going to come, those from drum is going to come into contact into the environment. So aapka kya hoga, emulsion homogeneity lose kar jata hai, because aapka environment contact mein aaya to pani kuch evaporate ho gaya, to pura density uska jo homogeneity stability hai, that will lose the stability. So always take emulsion from a closed drum. And before using emulsion, you have to roll it slowly for 3 to 4 times. You can't shake the emulsion like vigorously, you can't shake that emulsion. So you have to roll it slowly for 3 to 4 times or 5 times, then you can use that emulsion for your construction. And if you are having SS1 emulsion, RS2 emulsion in the field, and also MS emulsion, because premix, if you are going for a premix carpet, then you must have gone for the priming and tack coating. So if emulsions are there, so you can't mix all the emulsion together. Every emulsion application is different. So each emulsion, if that is RS2, then RS1, then you can use for the tack coating, SS1 for the priming, MS for the premix carpet. You can't mix all the emulsion together and go for the priming or tack coating. And water you can't use in the emulsion. It is not required to add extra water into the emulsion. If emulsion is your not giving the proper viscosity, if you are not able to pour that emulsion, if that is thick, then that emulsion you have to throw it. You can't add water into the emulsion. And similarly, you can't heat the emulsion, because that is also not recommended. You can't heat the emulsion. So type of surfacing we are using cold mix, as I have told that this cold mix is generally used for the low volume roads where the wearing course is not, we are not using for the structural capacity, we are not considered is as a structural layer because this is having some issue on we are not getting that much strength how much we need from the hot mix. If BCDVM, because in BCDVM high fine content and the density we are not achieving by this emulsion, so we are using for the surface only the thin surfacing. So surface dressing, open graded premix carpet over seal coat we have to do, as already sir told that it is very much required if you are going for a OGPC, over that you have to put a seal coat. So HDPC is there, which is a structural layer, and that is not in MORTH specification, but MORD specification says that you can go for HDPC using bitumen emulsion. And mixed seal surfacing is a surfacing is available which can be used by the bitumen emulsion. So first we are talking about surface dressing. So surface dressing is a preventive preservation and surface treatment, where in this surface dressing, first one layer of bitumen emulsion you have to put over the surface, then over that you have to put a chips layer, so that, and immediately you have to roll it after putting a binder, and over that bitumen chips, then you have to roll the surface. So this is known as surface dressing. हाँ जी एस बी जैसे आपका इमल्शन जो भी यस ओके हाँ जैसे आपका जो भी आपका डिज़ाइन में पढ़े हुए थे कि जी एस बी आ गया, उसमें डब्ल्यू बी एम ग्रेड वन ग्रेड टू आया, जो भी आया उसके ऊपर जो टॉप लेयर ओ जी पी सी है, ओ जी पी सी के मतलब ओ जी पी सी नहीं डालना है, इन दैट केस यू कैन पुट द सरफेस ड्रेसिंग, एंड ट्रैफिक शुड बी इन बिटवीन टी वन टू टी फाइव, देन यू कैन गो फॉर सरफेस ड्रेसिंग विदाउट पुटिंग ओ जी पी सी, यू कैन गो फॉर द सरफेस ड्रेसिंग ओ जी पी सी ट्रैफिक हाँ ओ जी पी सी सब्स्टिट्यूट है. हाँ ये जितना भी मिक्सिल सरफेसिंग ओ जी पी सी एंड सरफेस ड्रेसिंग ये तीनों एक दूसरे के रिप्लेसमेंट में आप कर सकते हैं, मतलब जहाँ पे आप ओ जी पी सी कर रहे हैं वहाँ पे यू कैन डू सरफेस ड्रेसिंग, एंड ऑल्सो मिक्सिल सरफेसिंग इज देयर, दैट ऑल्सो यू कैन डू बाद में है मिक्सिल सरफेसिंग. हाँ फर्स्ट लेयर नहीं, जैसे आपका ग्रैनुलर ख़त्म हो गया उसके ऊपर जब बी टी का लेयर आएगा छोटा सा 20 mm का, इन दैट केस यू कैन हैव द सरफेस ड्रेसिंग. हाँ प्राइम
हाँ व्हेनेवर देयर इज अ ग्रैनुलर लेयर यू आर पुटिंग अ बिटुमिनस लेयर यू हैव टू गो फॉर
प्राइमिंग के बाद आपका जैसे आप वन लेयर ऑफ बिटुमिन या इमल्शन का डालेंगे उसके ऊपर आप वन लेयर ऑफ चिप स्प्रेडिंग सिंगल ग्रेडेड चिप स्प्रेडिंग आप करेंगे तो उसके ऊपर रोलिंग करेंगे इसमें. This is the existing pavement, then you have to put a layer of bitumen, then over that single graded aggregate size you have to put, then you have to roll it. So this is known as single surface dressing. In India we are doing with double surface dressing, we are doing only with single and double surface dressing. In this case double surface dressing, first you have to put a layer of binder, then single graded, then you have to keep that road open for traffic for 1 week 2 weeks time, then after that after 2 weeks again you have to clean the road if the surface is having some dust or debris whatever that is, and you need to put a prime coat, then over that you can have one more layer of binder, then smaller side chip you have to put over that, so that it is double surface dressing we call it. So this chip is going to reduce the void, so this is double surface dressing we do in India. Yes ji size hai uska depending on the
jaise chip se bada wala 40 mm bhi asal pal
raha nahi 40 mm nahi
nahi surface dressing aur BOSB same hai
BOSB ना नहीं सेम
एंटर
नहीं अलग है डिफरेंट. सो इसमें चिप आपका 19 mm मैक्सिमम और मिनिमम 6 डिपेंडिंग ऑन द सरफेस हार्डनेस कि आपका जो ग्रैनुलर सरफेस है वो कितना हार्ड है उसके ऊपर डिपेंड करके दैट चिप साइज इज डिसाइडेड. अपर और दोनों आपका डिसाइड होता है डिपेंडिंग ऑन द ग्रैनुलर सरफेस हार्डनेस. सो वी डिसाइड द साइज ऑफ द चिपिंग. एंड so if we talk about Indian scenario then we are not using that much surface dressing, we are not using, and IRC 110 is there, 2005 code is available on specially on construction of surface dressing with bitumen, and emulsion is also there in that, and IRC SP 100 also it covers how to use surface dressing, and MORTS 5th edition, these are the codes available where the design specification is given for the surface dressing. So if I talk about surface dressing, after doing the surface dressing, how you can see whether this has been done, proper binder layer is there or not. So this is the layer of bitumen and over that we are putting aggregate. Then aap usme rolling karte hain. To jaise aap pehle rolling se pehle ye aapka voids hota hai, ye aise hota hai, and after rolling ye settle ho jata hai. तो ये जो थिकनेस है आपका जनरली वो एग्रीगेट का लेंथ जो है इसका 75% ऑफ लेंथ शुड बी कोटेड ओवर द कोटेड विद द बिटुमेन. दिस इज़ द फेनोमेना यू हैव टू सी एंड देखना है कि वेदर प्रॉपर कोटिंग इज नॉट देयर बाय विजुअल. यू हैव टू टेक द चिप आउट एंड यू कैन सी 75% कोट हुआ है या नहीं हुआ है नीचे. सो दैट इज़ द रिक्वायरमेंट. एंड दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द सर्फेस ड्रेसिंग हैज़ बिन डन इन कर्नाटका. So this is the top layer. If you see top layer, there is no binder. You are not able to see any binder over the over. नहीं नहीं ये top layer है. टॉप लेयर है. इसके नीचे आपका बाइंडर है, उसके ऊपर आपका चिप स्प्रेडिंग है, और ये आपका सरफेस ड्रेसिंग का टॉप है. उसमें आपको बाइंडर नहीं दिखेगा बिकॉज बाइंडर इज बिलो. बट व्हेन यू आर गेटिंग वन चिप आउट ऑफ दैट देन अबाउट 75% ऑफ दैट वन इज हैविंग द कोटिंग. बाइंडर बहुत कम दिखेगा आपको. ऐसा नहीं है कि फुल्ली कोटेड नहीं दिखेगा. जैसे आप OGPC या कहीं और देख रहे हैं, HDPC या कोई भी देखेंगे तो फुल्ली कोटेड दिखता है. बट इन दिस केस रोल करते
हैं.
नीचे पूरा बाइंडर का एक लेयर स्प्रे हुआ है उसके
ऊपर.
जैसे आप देखिए यहाँ पे कोई जैसे वॉइड्स नहीं है, आपका वॉइड्स कम हो गया.
देयर
आर नो वॉइड्स.
There must be small gaps where water will be retained. It may not percolate.
See, initially you have 50% gaps, then it is reduced to 20% of
then
water.
Water
Haan,
will,
after
but
travel.
Water will not go inside the pavement. It will
be...
It
will
not go inside the pavement.
It does not go below the pavement because we have coated the entire surface with that point. But obviously, the white sands mein thoda pani, it can retain. So it has almost...
Chips down there, kya bana diya yaar? Nahin, usse toh badhiya hai.
And it is the strength as per the literature, it will give you better strength, better life compared to OGPC. Because
better, this is much better compared to
OGPC.
OGPC.
Haan.
Surface dressing is over the bituminous surface. So why don't we go for the micro recess? This 1 mm thick actually. 10 mm thick, sorry. That will seal the surface and also improve the riding quality.
ये भी राइडिंग क्वालिटी नहीं, कॉस्ट वाइज सेम नहीं होता है. माइक्रो सर्फेसिंग इज हायर कॉस्ट वाइज एंड इट इज़ नॉट यूज्ड एज ए स्ट्रक्चरल लेयर. एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड दैट इट इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू गिव यू एनी लोड बियरिंग कैपेसिटी एंड रिपेयर. इफ रटिंग इज देयर देन इट कांट रिपेयर द प्रॉपर रटिंग. वी कांट रिपेयर विद द सर्फेस ड्रेसिंग एंड द रिक्वायर्ड साइज. देर आर डिफरेंट साइज लाइक 19 mm, 13 mm, 10 mm एंड 6 mm साइज आर वी कैन डू चिपिंग. वी कैन डू विद दिस साइज एंड दिस डिपेंडिंग ऑन द हार्डनेस ऑफ द सर्फेस एंड दैट कैलकुलेशन आई हैव नॉट शोन इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन बिकॉज इट्स ए टू लेंथी. and the requirement of quantity of aggregate required per square meter. If we are going for the 19 mm, then 0.015 cubic meter aggregate you need to put per square meter, and if you are talking about emulsion, then 1.8 kg of emulsion per square meter you are need to spray, and over that you have to spray the aggregate. Similarly, this surface pressing can also be done with the bitumen also. In case of bitumen, 1.2 kg you are need to spray, and in case of emulsion, 1.8. Similarly, if you are going for the smaller chip like 6 mm chip, then you need to have emulsion 1.1 kg per meter square emulsion is required.
What is the requirement of emulsion per square meter in case of 19 mm?
1.8 kg.
That is cubic meter. I am talking about in surface area wise. Per square meter, what is the thickness you are using?
Yeah, 1. Square meter mein, per square meter you are needing 1.8 kg of emulsion. नहीं, वो नीचे वाला लेयर में थिकनेस कम होगा ना, आपका नीचे लेयर में थिकनेस कम हो रहा है, सिंगल साइज एग्रीगेट. नहीं, 30 नहीं आएगी ना, 19 mm का एग्रीगेट है तो आपका अराउंड 20 से बिलो ही आएगा, और नीचे आपका इमल्शन है, इमल्शन विल गो अप. इफ यू सी दिस ग्राफ, स्प्रे आपका इमल्शन पहले वो पेवर से, पेवर नहीं, वो इमल्शन स्प्रेयर जो आता है उसमें स्प्रे करेंगे, उसके बाद चिप स्प्रेडिंग भी पेवर से नहीं होगा, चिप स्प्रेडर आता है तो उसमें आपको करना पड़ेगा, चिप स्प्रेडर से करना होगा सिंगल साइज, दैट यू नीड टू डू. मेरा नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में है आपका. सो एंड इफ यू आर गोइंग फॉर द इमल्शन, देन मिनिमम एयर टेम्परेचर शुड बी 10 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड, एंड आप एग्रीगेट वेदर इट इज़ डैम्प और ड्राई, एनी काइंड ऑफ एग्रीगेट कैन वर्क फॉर द इमल्शन. सो सेम प्रिपरेशन ऑफ बेस, इफ दैट इज़ ए WBM और WMM लेयर, देन यू हैव टू पुट ए, लाइक बिफोर दैट यू हैव टू पुट द प्राइम कोट, एंड यू हैव टू क्लीन द लेयर, देन यू कैन गो फॉर द सर्फेस ड्रेसिंग. एंड फॉर if there is a old bituminous surface, then you need to reduce the, like you need to treat the repair depression and pothole, you need to treat before going for the surface dressing. And application of binder through spraying unit, you have to apply, not by manually, you can't apply the binder. If you are going for the surface dressing, you need to apply using spraying unit, and the spraying unit you need to calibrate properly, because there are many issues. If the spraying is not properly calibrated, if there is overlapping spraying is there, then one layer will be excessive binder and other layer will be reduced, less content of binder. So you have to calibrate the spraying unit, and similarly the हाँ, टैग कोट एंड प्राइम कोट ऑल्सो यू नीड टू डू लाइक दिस, देन इट इज नॉट करेक्ट. हैंड स्प्रे स्मॉल एरिया नहीं, ये अवेलेबल है, इफ यू आर गोइंग टू डू इट देन इट इज, इट मस्ट बी अवेलेबल, ये मिल जाएगा.
ठीक है, that is allowed for smaller areas, but if you go by specification, it says it has to be through pressure distributor system, so that we have a proper
spray
uniform coverage of
the entire surface. Yes, and chip spreader, so this is a proper chip spreader, it is not available in India, but in India this tailgate type one is available. Weather track trailer, they have put one extension that is available very easily in India. So from that you can spray the chip. After the binder you have to spray the chip. And rolling, if emulsion is used, then after a day you can do the rolling, because you need some time for the curing of emulsion. And you need to see through visually how much rolling is required. In some times what happen, excessive rolling will crush your stone, so you have to check while rolling also.
How do you ensure that it is rolling? Because you, this chips on the track on top only, it will take time to come up, the emulsion.
No, not time, during rolling you can see that
it will take 2-3 days,
it won't take 2-3 days.
70% has actually penetrated
into this.
Assume like we are not
You can see.
Don't do it excessively that it crushes particles.
वो crushing होने से आपको दिख जाएगा कि ये crush हो रहा है aggregate का. तो then you have to stop the rolling. And ये जैसे आपका emulsion हो गया तो curing से पहले ये पूरा ऊपर तक रहेगा, with time आपका नीचे आएगा. तो 75% is about 70 to 75% it should be. And observation, if you are doing through a sprayer and chip spreader, then the distance between the sprayer and chip spreader should not be more than 30 meter. It should be between the 30 meter. Otherwise, if the distance is more, then time required is more, then breaking will happen. So proper embedment of aggregate into the emulsion won't be there. So you need to see that, and also you have to do the calibration, proper calibration of that chip spreading. Like this is the methodology for calibration. You have to put a pad, rubber pad. You know the weight of that rubber pad, and over that you have to run the chip spreader and also the spraying unit. Then you can weigh. That is the methodology to do the calibration for chip spreading and also for the spraying of the emulsion that is required. And also uniformity, to check the uniformity, each nozzle you are getting uniform spraying or not, because if other nozzles are not uniform, then one portion will be having more binder, other portion will be less binder. So in that case you have to check the uniformity through doing some initial study, initial checking, and all containers should have the same quantity of binder if you are running it for same time. So this is all about surface dressing. Then we are coming to open graded premix carpet. That this IRC 14-2005 code is available saying the open graded premix carpet, and IRC SP 100, and also MORTH and MORD specification is there for premix carpet. So in case of premix carpet, if we are going to use cationic emulsion, then IS 887, as per IS 887, we need to check medium setting, and paving bitumen and also modified bitumen can be used for the premix carpet, and people are using that one also. So that should be checked as per IS 73 and IRC SP 53. And these are the aggregate properties you need to check before going for the OGPC. And here one property, like aggregate sand equivalent test, is very critical property you need to check. That should be minimum 60. You need to check in case of OGPC, because whatever, if you are going for the emulsion mix, then the fine content of the aggregate dusty amount is very much essential to check. Otherwise, if dust material is more, then you need to add more emulsion. If you are adding the required quantity of emulsion, then you are going to reduce the binder. Like surface area is more, then you are reducing the coating. So as per the requirement, then coarse aggregate, there are two types of, in OGPC there are two types of aggregate generally used, for nominal size of 13.2 and other one is nominal size of 11.2. If we talk about 13.2, then passing through 22.4 and retained on 11.2, and if we talk about 11.2, passing through 13.2 and retained on 5.6. so this is the gradation, and the requirement per 10 square meter, that is 0.18 meter cube aggregate is required per 10 meter square of the area, and for this 13.2 nominal size, and for 11.2, 0.9. So total aggregate, if you see, then 0.27 cubic meter of aggregate is required for 10 meter square of the area. And depending on the, and what we need binder, then we need to have a binder 13 to 15 kg and 6 to 7 kg. And finally, we need around 19 to 22 kg of binder is required, like emulsion is required for 10 meter square of paving area. So same, we need to clean the base WBM and WMM, and then we have to put a prime coat. Then after proper curing of prime coat, we can go for the OGPC. And if you are going for the old bituminous surface, first we need to treat the portholes and also depression. Then we can clean that, and over that we can have the OGPC. And as per the caudal condition and laying condition, that should not be done. If surface temperature is below 10 degree centigrade, then we should not be doing OGPC with emulsion. And also rainy, if rainy rain is going on, then also we can't do the laying of that one. And similarly, we generally we do the OGPC through a concrete mixture. So weighted quantity like 11.2 and 13.2 mm aggregate we are putting. This is the by manually. We are putting the required quantity of aggregate first. Then over that we are putting the emulsion. Then through concrete mixture like 2 to 3 minutes we have to do the mixing. Then we can do it laying manually. So this is one method generally in all rural road people are adopting. Other method we can do using hot mix plant also. In that case you have to switch up the heating arrangement in the hot mix plant and you have to put an emulsion tanker. And pump you need to change because the bitumen pump, same pump is not going to use for the emulsion pumping. So you have to change the emulsion centrifugal pump you need to add there. Then you can do use the hot mix, existing hot mix plant from the you for the cold mix production. And through paver also you can lay and compact the pavement. And it is required to then over that you need to put a type A or type B seal coat. You after that you can pave or lay roll the OGPC. Then over that you need to put the seal coat. This seal coat is generally used to cover the voids available in the OGPC. So seal coat we do with two type of sealing is there, type A seal coat and other one is type B. Type A seal coat we call it as a liquid seal coat. That is similar with similar to the surface dressing. First you have to put a layer of bitumen emulsion, then over that you need to put a chip spreading over the, that is known as the liquid seal coat. And other one is type B seal coat where you have to mix the material aggregate and emulsion in a mixer, then you can lay it. So there are two type of seal coat, and depending on the type of seal coat, for type A the size is 6.7 mm size, passing through 11.2 and retain on 2.8 mm sieve, and there we need 0.09 meter cube of aggregate we are required for 10 meter square area. And similarly for type B we need a fine aggregate passing through 2.36 and retaining on 180 microns, and we are needing 0.06 meter cube of aggregate fine material over for the 10 meter square. And similarly if we are talking about the emulsion content, for type A we need 12 to 14 kg RS type emulsion we are needing, and RS2 type emulsion. And for type B premix seal coat ke liye hame 10 to 12 kg of emulsion is required for SS2.
जी.
We have done in CRRI at Himachal Pradesh and Maharashtra using OGPC seal coat. And then coming to the semi-dense bituminous concrete, that is a, as per IRC SP 100, we can go up to 40 mm thick using this SDBC, and SS2 emulsion is used. And as per IRC SP 100, tailor made emulsion name is also there, where emulsion is customized as per the aggregate gradation and aggregate properties. So this kind of emulsion can be used for preparation of HDBC, and this is the required gradation. And here we need to have 8 to 10% of emulsion is required for HDBC grading, 8 to 10%. And sand equivalent test we need to do at HDBC, that should be required is 50, is required minimum 50 we need for sand equivalent test for the HDBC. And this is a design mix, so we need to do laboratory mix design first. And this is the requirement in laboratory, 25 degree you need to check the stability, and stability value is 500 kg for 3 days after curing. And Marcel flow should be, should not be more than 8 mm in case of HDBC. And minimum you need to check the indirect tensile strength at laboratory to check the moisture susceptibility, to check whether moisture, the HDBC mix is moisture susceptible, resistance towards moisture damage or not, that you need to check at laboratory also, 75%. So these are the requirement, and these are some quality control, and tomorrow there is a lecture, so you are going to say, Shukla sir is going to detail, in detail he is going to give you a lecture on quality. So these are some works we have done in HDBC at Aizwal. So these are some photographs. Then coming to the mixed sill surfacing, this is same in case of OGPC seal coat, you can go for mixed seal surfacing. This is a single layer. There, in case of OGPC, you have to put a two layer. Like first OGPC, then seal coat you have to put. But in case of mixed seal surfacing, one layer you can add without any over any other layer. So same, you are having IRC SP 78-2008 specification if you want to go for mixed seal surfacing, and IRC SP 100 is there, and MORTH and MORD specification is there. And this is the gradation. There are for mixed seal surfacing also there are two type, type A and type B. So this is the gradation, and quantity of aggregate required is 0.27 meter cube per 10 meter square area. And if we are going for the type A, then we are needing 32 kg of emulsion for 10 square meter area, and similarly for type B 30 kg and SH2 emulsion is required. So the aggregate properties you need to check before going for MSS, and these are some quality control tests you need to do while going for MSS. And this is one work we have done in Andhra Pradesh using MSS. And precaution, what we need to do, precaution we need to check. Because in case if the fine content is more, or if you are using an aggregate having very high dust element, then the there will be a lump formation will be there when we are mixing. So if lump formation is there, then we have to change the aggregate type. We can't use that aggregate. That is the main problem. And also if you are going for the concrete mixture, if we are using concrete mixture, then fine content is settling behind the mixer, like within the mixer, the fine content, there is a layer of fine content is settles there. So after 2-3 times, 5 times mixing, the fine, your mixing is, your gradation, whatever you are getting, you are not getting the proper gradation. So you need to clean the concrete mixture with after 2-3 mixing, that is also required. And also if you are doing with a hot mix plant, if the site is very far from the mixing site, from the laying site far, then if the emulsion is break in between, then the laying, you can't, it is very difficult for the lay. So this is one, so left portion is a emulsion, is having brown color, where setting is, like breaking is not there, but this is a breaking emulsion. अगर आपका ऐसे वाला इमल्शन है, ब्राउन कलर है, देन यू कैन ले इट. इफ़ इमल्शन इज सेटल डाउन, लाइक ब्रेकिंग इज देयर, ब्लैक हो गया है, देन आप ले नहीं कर सकते. सो यू हैव टू हैव ए, एंड ले कर नहीं सकते इफ़ इट इज़ नॉट लाइक ब्रेकिंग नहीं हुआ है, तो उसके ऊपर आप कॉम्पैक्ट नहीं कर सकते. आफ्टर ब्रेकिंग ओनली यू कैन गो फॉर द कॉम्पैक्शन. दैट यू नीड टू टेक केयर वाइल कंस्ट्रक्टिंग ऑन द फील्ड. इफ़ इमल्शन हैज़ ऑलरेडी नॉट ब्रेक, if that is not in black color, then you can't compact. After breaking only you have to compact the emulsion. So these are some issue at site we got to know from site engineers only. And emission and energy, some calculation we have done in CRRI. So how much if we are using premix carpet and mixed seal surfacing using same emulsion and same hot mix like conventional, because as per codal provision you can go for emulsion and you can use hot mix bitumen also for calculation, like for construction of premix carpet and mixed seal surfacing. So fuel consumption is, in case of hot mix you are consuming about 1700 liter of fuel for constructing 1 kilometer of road, 3.5 width, whereas if you are constructing with emulsion, then the consumption is 90 liter. So you are saving lots of fuel. And similarly, emission data is there. So through hot mix, you are emitting for constructing 1 kilometer for OGPC. You are emitting about 190 tons of CO2 emission, whereas in case of cold mix, only 40 tons of CO2 you are emitting.
Can you just go back to the last?
Yes.
Bitumen we are using much lesser. Emulsion is on the higher side.
Huh, because bitumen emulsion is having 40% water. Yes, 60% is emulsion binder and 40% water. So whatever residual binder is there, that you have to use. So because of that, emulsion bitumen content is less. In case of emulsion, you have to use higher emulsion if you compare with the bitumen. Okay. And the way forward, like what we are working in CRRI, so we are trying to use cold mix for the structural layer for BC or DBM to have a high strength. And also we are working for the categorized surface dressing, where we are seeing to work like where we can use surface dressing as per the different, because in UK we are only doing single and double layer surface dressing, but there are many types of surface dressing depending on the traffic and surface. So, and also in CRRI we have developed one porthole repair machine using cold bituminous mix. So this is here through compressor we can clean the porthole, tack coat, and we can prepare the mix, then we can put it, then compact it. So for all the type of thing we can do this using this machine. So we have developed this one, and also we are working with MOEFCC, Ministry of Environment, and we have developed one mixture cum paver, because generally whatever the concrete cold mix is done using concrete mixture, which is not going to give you the quality, is not we are getting proper quality. So for that we have developed one small unit where you can mix and compact pave, sorry not compact, you can mix the mix and pave the unit like bituminous layer using this same unit. It is specially for the hilly region, because in hilly region the space is not there and we can't have set up for the hot mix plant. So on this we are working, and these are some issues. Administration issues are there. So thank you so much. Initially cold mix as per the DPI, matlab jo bhi available hai abhi tak, initially that is 5 to 10% higher aata hai, but if life cycle, yes, because you are using more emulsion compared to bitumen, and emulsion cost is at par or higher to binder. Initial it is higher, but if you see the life cycle and fuel, we are not checking. We are working on that, ki on basis of fuel consumption, because already 1700 to 19 liter of fuel we are saving. So on that we are not checking. Overall, agar fuel ko aap include karenge, to cold mix aapka sasta padega. But general.
Include the cost of damaging environment. So overall that is going to be cheaper, but quantification as of we have not done, like how much environment we are degrading because of use of hot mix. So if you include that quantification also, cold mix is going to be cheaper.